First of all, we're gonna prepare the mud. Usually, if you have a full bucket like this, you might wanna have another container to mix it in and put some mud in there and don't fill it up. I wouldn't even go half full, maybe a quarter of the way full. And the mud's a little bit thicker, and depending on what type of texture you want, if you want a heavier or light one, you might wanna add a little bit of water to it, maybe a half a cup to a quarter bucket, and just see how it goes. You start out slow, mixing this in. You can increase the speed after it gets going. You're not splattering anywhere. You get it good and mixed. I've kind of mixed that already before, so save time. We'll just go with that. And then you probably want to take it out and put it into the. We've got this water heater pan here, just a surface where you can kind of spread it out a little bit. And we'll just do some for now. And then you have this little mop room. You can wet it up a little bit, and it depends on the texture you want, like I say. Get it on there good. So you basically want to take this mop, and when you first put it on, there's going to be a lot at first. So you kind of want to spread it out a little bit, and you can always come back, and you want to turn this kind of in a random fashion. But as you do it, you keep coming back to some of those thick areas and putting it where it needs it. So, I'm trying to cover up any imperfections that might be there. And we can show you over here where we've prepared the ceiling a little bit, where this ceiling needed a little bit more work because of some settling cracks, and we put some mud on there before, sanded it, and kind of blended it, smoothed it out a little bit. Areas that you hit with mud that are really light, that didn't need a lot of sanding, you might not need to sand. That's the whole point of the texturing, is to cover up those imperfections. But if there's a big major area like this, you'll want to prepare it a little bit more. But after you get this, and this is kind of a light, I'm doing kind of a lighter texture on the ceiling, just so that it, as far as cleaning, you don't want to leave like big pointy areas, where the mud's pulled back. And the other thing you do, you can leave it like that if you do it really thin and you make kind of a pattern, whatever pattern you want. But you can also take, when you're finished with that, you do an area. And you can take a spatula like this and just hold it at an angle really lightly. And it'll take some practice to figure out what you want. And you kind of just, what they call a knocking it down. Sometimes there'll be a line like that. You'll just have to kind of get the feel for it. And knock it down. And the reason for that is it just makes it smoother, easier, so it doesn't collect that dirt. It's easier to clean. And you'll do a section like that, or you can have someone help you. You can do an area, a bigger area with two people, and kind of get the person with the mop goes ahead of them, gets an area, and then the person comes in behind them. And with this mud, it's just a topping compound. It's in this, for the finishing, a drywall wall on seams and that. It sounds really easy, but that's pretty much all you need to do for that, and just continue on throughout the whole ceiling. And then just let it dry.
And then once you're done, do you go through and give it a light sand, or?
It depends on how heavy you're doing. With this particular style, it doesn't require any sanding.
Okay.
You can do a skip trowel type. There's another form that you can do with a skip trowel. It might be a little heavier, and sometimes you'll go with the pole sander and hit some, maybe some bigger areas, depending on how thick you go with it.
Perfect. And so then this is the finished product here from what you've already done. Should look something like that, just to give you an idea.